Hi, meteorologist Peter Hall. Here's your NBC3 forecast. Well, we have another very warm day on tap for you, but it's our last one, so let's savor it. We should be in the 70s again today. We should have more sunshine than anything else. Now, there's going to be some extra clouds for eastern and southern areas compared to, let's say, Syracuse and Auburn and Fulton and Oswego and Watertown. All these areas I just mentioned will have more in the way of sun than everybody else. It then gets windy this afternoon. Expect the wind through tonight as well. We'll stay dry during the day. I can't rule out a shower at 8, but the best chances for the wettest weather comes at and after midnight. Well, temperatures are actually going to stay above normal through tomorrow morning and then start dropping. So, we have on tap today, warmth with wind. Yep. We haven't had much wind recently, so this may be something a little eye-popping and eyebrow-raising because, well, we're going to have wind gusts of 30 to 40 miles per hour later this afternoon through tonight. We've mentioned some rain. I've mentioned also maybe a shower if you're going to a Friday night high school game, if you're going to the Syracuse Orange game, if you're going out to dinner or going to a friend's house or out to watch the game. I can't rule out a shower in the evening. But the most rainfall, the wettest weather, happens late tonight through tomorrow morning. We are still on tap for some much cooler weather. If we don't get to 60, it would be the coolest day in over 4 months. The last time we did not break 60 in Syracuse, May 23rd. It'll be close, somewhere in the upper 50s to near 60. Regardless, Sunday is definitely going to be chilly, although not horrendous sky-wise because there should be some sunshine. Let's take a look at the futurecast. You can see some of the cloud cover to the south. What's not shown here on the futurecast, it is also cloudy from about Rome, Norwich, Lowville, east. So it's pretty cloudy here this morning, too, over there. Otherwise, sunshine, a few clouds, breezy, but beautiful. It's going to be in the mid-70s to upper 70s for Syracuse, Watertown, and downtown Ithaca. Further to the south and east, though, we'll probably end up in the lower 70s. Let's look at the rainfall. Any rain at 5? Nope. Well, game's at 7 p.m. for SU. I can't completely rule out a shower, but I think the best chances for rain comes at around 11 or midnight and then thereafter. You could see more in the way of green on the map, right? And with 8 in the morning tomorrow, there's still rain in the area. We've got a call for some rain in the morning. We've been very consistent telling you that there would be some leftover rain Saturday. So when does it end? It's going to be a slow process from west to east to get the rain out. What does that mean for you? Well, I think it's going to rain Syracuse in the 81 corridor through the morning and then taper off in the afternoon. Traveling to eastern New York or in east central New York, Old Forge, Little Falls will be the last for the rain to end, and it may not end until the end of the day. Eastern New York may actually rain through tomorrow night. Anyway, we've talked about Sunday being chilly, right? But there's also going to be a lot of sun. Look at all the clear sky you see in the morning. The most consistent showers are going to occur in Watertown in the Jefferson County, St. Lawrence County area Sunday because of a southwest wind with lake effect rain showers. You're going to notice it. See it right there? Elsewhere in central New York, we have sun and then afternoon clouds, maybe a brief shower. So sky-wise, in central New York, not terrible, but it's just chilly. You can see all the lake effect rain showers up north. The amount of sunshine we've got for you, 80% today. 10% sun tomorrow, 50% sunshine on Sunday. Precipitation probability. It's not going to rain during the day, but it should rain, especially later tonight, and at least for parts of tomorrow. We've talked about maybe a late day shower Sunday, otherwise dry. The chance of a shower is about 1 in 3 for central New York, much higher in Jefferson County. And then it's a little kind of shaky on a chance of a shower for the rest of next week, although next week is going to be much more seasonable. Here's your 7-day forecast. You can find a lot more on our website. It's on cnycentral.com.